Well, I hear beginning of July, building some arrows for this fall. I'm going to be shooting the VAP TKO 350s, the Elite series. I mean, they got a straightness of .001. Super, super awesome arrow. I've been shooting it for 5 years and I've absolutely fallen in love with it. I like shooting a micro diameter arrow. When you're shooting further distances, you just get less wind drift on it. And it's got the ice coating on there over that woven carbon. Helps it penetrate. It's a real slick arrow. It penetrates really, really well. Have the standard 50 grain insert that comes with it. Really like that up front. Adds a little bit of weight, a little bit more driving force going in there. On the back end, I'll put a nocturnal in there before I hunt. I shoot a real low profile vane. I like that, just get less drag. And when I'm building my arrows, the first thing I do, put a wrap on there. I like shooting a wrap. I use a shorter one. I get wraps the standard length, cut them in half. That way I can get two arrows out of each wrap, just personal preference. Then I put a little mark on there and I go out and stand 3 or 4 yards from the target. Shoot into it a few times. I just want to see which way that arrow is rotating coming out of the bow without fletchings on it. So my bow, it shoots the arrows counterclockwise. So I'm going to go with the left helical or offset. I run a 2-degree offset. I don't like going too far. That's perfect for me. I shoot an expandable broadhead, so I don't need a lot of steering on the back of the arrow as guys with a fixed blade would use. So I run that 2-degree offset with that low profile vane. It's worked really, really good. When I shoot out at long distances, I don't get as much drag. It seems to perform really, really well for me. So this is the arrow I'm gonna be shooting this fall. Absolutely love it. I've killed a lot of deer with it and it's performed extremely well. So gonna continue to use it. So if you're in the market for a new arrow, maybe check out the VAP TKO.